Hi, thank you for watching vNode Modbus Slave Model Configuration. Today we are going to talk about the vNode Modbus Slave Model, which is a slave Modbus. In this case, vNode will act, first of all, taking data from any kind of data source, and then it will map over a Modbus slave device with the model that we are going to cover today. Okay. So first of all, we need to log it in under the vNode platform. First of all, you have to type in the local address or IP address from the server which vNode is already installed and put the port number, which is just a predefined number, okay? And then using the login credential, you will be using the user as an admin and password called vNode in case sensitive, okay? Once you get in, you are going to approach the configuration platform pane, okay? Under models, create a new model. In this model, give it a name, Modbus Slave. I'm gonna put it right here. And under Modbus model type, you will be selecting the Modbus server model right here. Okay. Hit on save. And after that, on your left side of the window, it will appear again under model Modbus Slave already created. To start configuring the model, first of all, you need to create a new channel right here. I'm gonna put it like a unit. And then under Modbus mode, you are going to select TCP or even RTU encapsulated. I'm going to use the TCP modules, okay? Which is also the port number will be the predefined or the standard port for Modbus 502. And then under devices, you are going to create the slave environment, the slave device, okay? So in this case, I'm going to put it like slave. And under the slave address, I'm going to select one slave address of my choice, okay? Remember that you are creating a Modbus slave device right here, so you have the full freedom to start configuring as you want. So I'm going to put it like a slave address on one, okay? And then we have to configure any kind of offset for the Modbus address, buffer size, the swap from the bytes. Or bits, and also you are going to create a map group. What is a map group? A map group is the part in which we are going to link the data source the data that is coming from any kind of data sources that vNode is already collecting. I don't know if you are working with PLCs, if you are working with OPC server, if you are working with, I don't know, like databases, if you are looking to take data from sensors or any kind of device or industrial device. Once you do this, the map group will link that data with a Modbus addressing environment in which you will be selecting which Modbus register will be linked to that tag. Okay, so on the map group, create a new tag map. Okay, I'm gonna put the tag map, okay? And under tag map, you're going to select which is the tag map you're going to work. So create a tag map under here, give it a name. I don't know, like, let's put it like Modbus to OPC to Modbus. Why OPC to Modbus is because we have an OPC server already connected to vNode automation platform. And we are looking and we are reading some kind of data. So we're going to do this kind of exercise, like linking the OPC data to Modbus slave model from vNode automation. Okay. So under tag, you are going to select the tag. In this case, that it will be mapped to Modbus address. So I have already created an OPC tag right here that is coming from other environment. Okay. And then I'm going to map the value of the tag, which is mean that I'm going to see the same value in Modbus address, right? Data type, it will be like a integer of 16. And also the Modbus address we need to use is the one that we are going to choose in this case. I'm going to use like a holding register. So I'm going to use the 40s, all right? And hit on save, okay. Go right here. Okay, if everything is okay, we need to start testing it, the full solution with the Modbus master. If we are working with, I don't know, like SCADA, we are sending data to another master Modbus in your platform, in your environment, actually we are going to use the Modbus pool, right? Modbus pool is actually a solution or environment, okay? So we're start going to use a Modbus master, in this case the Modbus pool, okay? And then we're going to connection, over connect, release later, this is like a trail key. And then you will be selecting the Modbus TCP IP protocol. And then after that, you have to type the IP address of the vNode, the slave model, which in this case is localhost, and then the server port number, in this case 502, okay? Hit an okay, and then go to setup. We don't write definition, hit the slave ID, which is the same as slave ID. We already created and set up a vNode automation platform. And after that, you will be linked to address. In this case, it will like, this one. I'm gonna put it as 0, start in 1, and then the quad it, okay? Hit an apply. So actually we are going to see that the data is already coming here on over Modbus protocol right here. So if you go back to vNode automation, you are seeing that in the under tags that we already created, we have an OPC tag actually right here. That is coming from any OPC server, in this case from Matrix and OPC. And then on the real time, you will see that that tag, it is collecting data, okay? So if you see that the same data that we are looking over OPC, we are looking over Modbus platform, okay? Modbus protocol in this case. So actually, this is part of the configuration of the model. Remember that if you need any kind of help or assistance, please contact us to the following emails, accounts for support, and also commercial for sales or info to vNode automation platform, all right? So thank you very much for your time today. Hope this will be really helpful for your implementation, and let us know if you need something else more in the future. So thank you very much. We really appreciate it. Have a great time. Bye-bye.